Carl had no trouble recognizing his employer. He had been killed. There was no need to be a detective to figure that out. But only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close, that the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized. Could be inside that envelope. Carl was taken aback. He knew this address. It was said to be the address of the P.O. box for the Canadian Secret Service. Jumping from that height was akin to tempting death. Perhaps that man on the snowmobile had seen enough of this world already. A nice picture of the Magasin La Chance store, seemingly taken the day it was first opened. It feels frozen in time, from an era long forgotten. Amateur hunters showing some pride at having killed a nice pelted beast. With men like this roaming the area, wolves would become extinct within 10 years, Carl thought. Maintaining his composure, Carl recalled something from his military training. Wolves always stay away from populated areas. Wait, was it about bears? Hate was in the air. Seems like some villagers barely tolerated each other. A milkman had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit. Carl, like many of his contemporaries, felt like he had more trouble breathing when he wasn't smoking. Cigarette was his own personal breathing assistant. According to that log, it seemed like the whole village owed some money to the general store. Carl was far more interested in the bunch of nearby addresses he had just gotten his hands on, though. The snowstorm pummeled everything in its path. Carl was not surprised when he heard no tone. Carl knew that Gilles Lachance was in charge of the general store. That made him one of Hamilton's employees. A very angry employee, as Carl could plainly see. Carl was used to strange phenomena, but a chunk of ice like this, as if an iceberg came out of the ground, that was a first. Prince? Carl found a surprise at every turn. Was the camera faulty, or was it a possible lead? Something fell to the bottom of the box. The murder weapon. What was that doing there, Carl wondered. Hamilton must have been determined to keep some information secret to post this key. Shame he got unlucky. Everything made sense now. Poor Hamilton's denunciation was interrupted, and he figured it would be best to lock everything up and send the key to his correspondent, who would receive the box later on. Clever, but not enough. That's what happens to ordinary people playing spy. Explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time. A radiator without power is as good as a wood stove without logs. A radiator without power is as good as a wood stove without logs. Staring intently at the controls won't be enough to make that lift budge. The poor thing was out of power. Staring intently at the controls won't be enough to make that lift budge. The poor thing was out of power. Note, explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time. the note, explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time. The note explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time. At long last, the crowbar was within Carl's grasp. Surely it would come in handy at some point. Carl felt that the store and its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out.